विघ्नो शांतये। रामाय राम भद्राय रामचंद्राय वेधसे रघुनाथाय नाथाय सीताया पतये नमः। कूजन तम राम रामेति मधुरम मधुराक्षरम आरुह्य कविता शाखा वंदे वाल्मीकि कोकिलम अंजनानंदनम वीरम जानकी शोकनाशनम कपीशमक्षहंतारम वंदे लंका भयंकरम। नमोस्तु रामाय सलक्ष्मणाय देव्यै च तस्यै जनकात्मजायै। नमोस्तु रुद्रेन्द्र यमानिलेभ्यो नमोस्तु चंद्रार्क मरुद्गणेभ्यः। ओम नमः परमहंसास्वादित चरण कमल चिन्मकरंदाय भक्तजन मानस निवासाय श्री रामचंद्राय। ओम सो आई वाज सेइंग दैट वी आर जस्ट फिनिश्ड द 13th सर्गा एंड वी आर गोइंग टू एंटर द 14th सर्गा एंड द कॉन्टेक्स्ट इज दैट द यज्ञाश्व हैज बीन लेट लूज एंड देन वन ईयर इट हैज टू रोम अराउंड फॉर वन ईयर एंड देन इफ एनीबडी इज चैलेंजिंग वेर एवर इट गोज इफ एनीबडी इज चैलेंजिंग द अथॉरिटी ऑफ दशरथ then he captures that horse and Dasharatha has to win over that person, over that king, and then that re-establishes Dasharatha's authority over that place. It's like the king accepting Dasharatha's authority either by letting the horse enter there or if he loses the war battle with Dasharatha, then ultimately, of course, anyway, he is now a subordinate of Dasharatha, subordinate king of Dasharatha. Last week, before we enter into the sarga proper, so last week I was telling you about Nayayika's, karanam. So they have 9 karanams towards everything. So and that's how Dasharatha, that's how Valmiki shows here in Ramayana sargas, in the initial sarga and Dasharatha's Ashwamedha Yaga, I told. So I thought today I will tell you about Mimamsakas. So Mimamsakas have, I'm just giving some information. So Mimamsakas, these things will be useful if you happen to study, let's say, so-called advanced text of Vedanta in the future. So these things will be useful also. So I'm telling these with that intention also. So Mimamsakas have something. You can see even those things here, what Mimamsakas say, that before you undertake any act, and this is very practical, we can use it in our daily life also. And we do it, in fact. So Nayayikas and Mimamsakas, both of them are realists. And they say things which we already know in some sense. Only thing that Mimamsakas also have something. So they say you have to consider these things before you do any action, before you undertake any action. And we in fact do it that way. We psychologically or whatever, consciously or unconsciously, take these 4 things into consideration and then only act. So what I was saying is Nayayikas and Mimamsakas are realists. And they say things that after you listen to what they are saying, they give very detailed explanations. But then what are they saying is something that's already in our experience. But they come in a roundabout way. That roundabout way, there are 2 ways. So Nayayikas come up with a roundabout way in a very technical sense. Mimamsakas come about, they also have a roundabout way. But they have, they have very kind of strange explanations also sometimes. But anyway, the current thing, what I'm trying to say, is very practical. We can see it in our lives. We do it, in fact, and you can see that Dasharatha is also doing it that way. So what is that? So that you have to take into consideration 4 things before undertaking any action. And the first thing is, so you have you want to undertake a result and an action, and that action is undertaken for a particular result. So you have a result in mind and then you want to undertake an action. So for that, what are the considerations before you undertake the action? What are the considerations? First thing, So you have to have these 4 types of jnanam. What is the first jnanam is? So, idam mama ishta sadhanam. So the action that you want to undertake has to give you, so it's the means to get your desired result. So you have an ishta, so your desired result, and this action should be the sadhanam, the means to achieve that that result. So idam mama ishta sadhanam, that jnanam you should have. Then idam mama kriti sadhyam. So that action that you want to undertake should be in your capability, so you should be able to do that action. If it's beyond your capability, then obviously there's no question of you taking it up. So the second jnanam that you should have is, so idam mama kriti sadhyam, it should be within your capability. And the third one is idam balavad anishta ananubandhi. So the action that you want to undertake should be something for which there is no it's not attached with something that you strongly dislike. So suppose I want to go to a movie or something, but I don't have a means of transport. Let's say I have to take a public transport and go, but I don't want to go in a public transport because COVID is around, something like that. So it should not be attached with something that you strongly dislike. So Balavad Anishta Ananubandhi, it should be Ananubandhi, not attached with Balavad Anishtam. So something that you strongly dislike, or in the Yajna Veda, Vedic rituals context, it is something, I mean, the doshas are so strong that the prayashchitta for the dosha is very difficult to perform. That should not be there. That's the context in which they are speaking. So Mimamsakars are speaking in the context of yajnas and yagas. So what they mean by that is, it should not be attached with a very strong kind of undesirable result, which is strongly disliked by you. And also, it should not lead you to naraka and things like that. So such things also you should be, you should not be wanting. So for example, there are some yagas, so Shiena yaga and things like that, which to Shatru Samhara is the result of that yaga. But then if you perform that yaga, ultimately you will go to naraka also. So that's what they are talking about. You should, that karma should not be such a karma that it gives you ultimately an undesirable, extremely undesirable result. That should not be there. So anyway, the third thing is, so Balavad Anishta Ananubandhi, it should not be attached with something that is extremely undesirable to you. And the fourth one is Upadana Karana Pratyaksham. So what is the things that constitute the action? So these four things are required. So this, you can take it as Iti Kartavyata, how you should do a particular thing. So you should have the modus operandi or something like that. So or the instruction manual, how you have to do a particular thing, that also you should know. Once you have these four jnanams, then you have to undertake any action. And that's how we do. That's what they say. So these four knowledges are required. So idam mama ishta sadhanam, idam mama kirti sadhyam, so idam balavad anishta ananubandhi, and the fourth one is upadana karana pratyaksham. These four things. So interestingly, in Jaimini Sutras, so these four topics are discussed in chapter 4. The first topic, idam mama kirti, idam mama ishta sadhanam, is discussed in chapter 4 of Jaimini Sutras. Chapter 5 discusses, so idam mama kirti sadhyam, so that is discussed. And in 6th chapter, so 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, that's what I'm trying to say. In 6th chapter, the Balavad Anishta Ananubandhi aspect is discussed. And in 7th and 8th chapters, the Upadana Karanam, as in what constitutes the Yaga. So Ashwamedha is a Yaga, but then it has many parts within it. So there are some parts which constitute this ritual called Ashwamedha that we are talking about. So those things, not just in Ashwamedha sense, but in any Yajna sense. So these things are discussed in Jaimini Sutras in 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 chapters. So that you can see here, even Dasharatha, so he decides that he wants to do Ashwamedha because it gives a result that he wants. So he wants Putra, so some children, Santanartham, we have been seeing in previous Sargas. For the sake of Santana, he wants to do this. So that first aspect is taken care of. And then it is within his means. So he keeps telling his ministers, this is something that is within, you people are capable of doing such things, he keeps saying. And then Balavad Anishta Ananubandhi, so he takes care of, and that also in the form of telling his ministers, in the form of inviting Rishyasringa, so he's taking care of that aspect. And then Upadana Karana Pratyaksham, so he knows, and then his Purohitas are there to guide him as to what is to be done exactly. And that details, so why am I trying to say all this is, so in this chapter specifically, you will see in a brief manner, what are the things that constitute the Ashwamedha Yaga itself. So that you will see in this chapter. So I thought I will tell you these things. So before we get into the chapter, now we get into the chapter proper. So Atha Chaturdasha Sargaha, Atha Samvatsare Purne Tasmin Prapte Turangame Saravya Shtottare Tire Ragnyo Yajnyo Bhyavartata Yajnyo Bhyavartata. So Atha Samvatsare Purne, so like I told, even the last chapter started like that. So 1 year since the time, so he has left the horse loose, now 1 year has passed. So now he is, now it's the time for the Yaga proper to be commenced. I mean the Yajnashva is brought back, and then it has to be, so Turangame Prapte, the Turanga means horse. So once that Turanga horse is brought back, Prapte, so once it's brought back or successfully it's been defended by, and then I think I lost the connection. I don't know, there's some problem today it seems. So let's try and continue as much as we can. So what I'm trying to say, that horse Turangame Prapte, that horse which has been let loose 1 year back is now brought back. And then एंड देन नाउ दैट दिस हैज हैपेंड सर्वया स्तोत्रे तीरे राग राग्ञो यज्ञो अभ्यवर्तत सो राग्ञः यज्ञः अभ्यवर्तत द यज्ञ ऑफ द किंग दैट मीन्स यज्ञ दैट हैज बीन स्टार्टेड इनिशिएटेड बाय द किंग दैट यज्ञ हैज स्टार्टेड अभ्यवर्तत सो सर वेयर डिड इट स्टार्ट सर्वया स्तोत्रे तीरे ऑन द नॉर्दर्न बैंक्स ऑफ सरयू दिस वी हैव सीन शिष्यशृंगं पुरस्कृत्य कर्मचक्र द्विजर्षभाः अश्वमेधे महायज्ञे राज्ञोस्य सुमहात्मनः सो ऋष्यशृंगं पुरस्कृत्य द्विजर्षभाः कर्मचक्रुः सो ऑल दीज ग्रेट ब्राह्मणास द्विजर्षभाः ऋष्यशृंगं पुरस्कृत्य दे कीप ऋष्यशृंगा इन फ्रंट दैट मीन्स दे कीप ऋष्यशृंगा एज द लीडर ऑफ वॉट एवर दे आर डूइंग एंड देन दे स्टार्ट दिस यागा कर्मचक्रुः So they do the yaga. So here, anyway, let me finish that. Ashwamedhe Mahayagne Ragnyosya Sumhatmanaha. So in that yaga of that king, so in that Ashwamedha yaga, which has been desired to be performed by that king. So Mahatmanaha Ragnyaha means of that Mahatma Raja Dasharatha. In that Ashwamedha yaga, so these people kept Rishyashringa in front of them. That means they kept Rishyashringa as their leader and they started. So there is Matadvayam here, in every Yaga, and let me tell you this information also because it comes in the Sarga. So in every Yaga, so you have five people, four Ritviks and one Yajaman. So who are those four Ritviks? So you have somebody called Hota, and then you have somebody called Adhvaryu, and then you have somebody called Udgata, and the fourth one is Brahma. So Hota, so there are four people, four of them have responsibilities, certain specific responsibilities, and each of them is in charge for one each of the Vedas. So the Hota is, he chants the invocations, so he is responsible for chanting the invocations and inviting Devatas and things like that. So he's responsible for, I mean, he chants mantras which belongs to Rig Veda. And then there's Adhvaryu is, he's responsible for mantras of Yajurveda. He chants mantras of Yajurveda, and he's also the technical expert, let's say, because he has to take care of the specifics of the yaga, and then he's the one who performs the yaga also. He's the one who does, who pours the oblation or something like that. So Adhvaryu. And then there's Udgata. Udgata is person who chants these Samaveda mantras, and then he also sings praises of devatas and things like that. So Udgata. So and then fifth is Brahma. Brahma is the overall supervisor. So he supervises the yaga, as in is everybody doing their things properly and things like that. He supervises the yaga, and when the necessity comes, he recites mantras of Atharva Veda. So this Brahma, Udgata, Adhvaryu, Hota. There are four people, four Ritviks, and then there is Yajaman, who is the actual kind of performer. I mean, so he is the one who, in his name the yaga is performed. He is performing the yaga, and then the actual details are, I mean, the yaga proper is performed by these four people, and then each of them have four assistants each. So I mean, that's a different count, but suffice to this sarga, what you should know is there are four people. So Hota, Adhvaryu, Udgata and Brahma, who are in that order, they pertain to these, I mean, they chant these mantras of Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda and Atharva Veda. So this Rishyashringa, is he the Brahma or is he the Adhvaryu? That's the debate. I mean, debate as in that's the discussion that these Tikakaras are taking up. So the majority opinion seems to be that he is the Brahma. He is the Pradhana. Brahma is a Pradhana Ritvik. He's the supervisor of everything that is happening. So these people are telling, they are, so Maheshwara Tirtha, and then Govinda Raja, and then Shiva Sahaya, who's the Shiromani Kara. So they are all saying that Rishyashringa is the Brahma, the Pradhana Ritvik, because so Rishyashringam Puraskritya, this came before also in the earlier sargas. So Rishyashringa, they are keeping Rishyashringa in front and they are doing. But then because like at least I did the Pratignya that we will follow Tilaka Tika mainly. So Tilakakara is saying no, it cannot be that he is the Brahma. He seems to be the Adhvaryu, because see, going ahead in the next sarga, you will see that Rishyashringa, so Valmiki says Rishyashringa did the yaga. That means he poured the oblation. So he says like that. So Brahma doesn't do that, Adhvaryu does that. So Rishyashringa is the Adhvaryu for this yaga. So so I brought this up because Tilakakara specifically negates the other view and brings up this view. Anyway, so Rishyashringam Puraskritya. So it means that even the Adhvaryu has some important role, you know, like I said, he's a technical expert. So you can take it in that sense. So Rishyashringam Puraskritya shows that he is the Adhvaryu and not the Brahma, is what Tilakakara is standing out and saying specifically. He is negating the other view, and he's showing in the next sargas, these shlokas are coming, the meaning of the shloka, contradicts if you are concluding that Rishyasringa is the Brahma. Anyway, so karma kurvanti. So this is a big sarga today. So we will do half of it perhaps. Let's see how much time allows, and then we will do the next remaining in the next session. Karma kurvanti vidhivad yajaka veda paragaha yatha vidhi yatha nyayam parikramanti shastrataha. So karma kurvanti vidhivat. So yajakaha veda paraga. Yajaka is these people who are performing the yaga. So the ritviks. So karma kurvanti vidhivat karma kurvanti. They are performing the ashwamedha yaga according to the vidhi, and they are veda paragaha. So this veda paraga has been coming earlier also. So I've been telling that Veda Paraga means one who has seen the end of the Vedas. That means I have studied the Veda completely. In this shloka, so Tilakakara is giving a nice definition of Veda Paraga. He is telling Veda Paragaha Adhitasya Vedasya Param Phalavad Arthava Bodham Gachanti Prapnuanti Veda Paragaha. So Veda Paraga means not just they have studied the Vedas, but they have also studied the meaning of the Vedas. So what Vedas they have already let's say committed to memory. That Vedas, they have studied the meaning of theirs also. That used to be that even now that's the style. So initially you learn the text of the Vedas. So you by heart the text of the Vedas, and then you have to. So swadhyayo adhyetavyaha, when you say, so you have to, each one has to study their own swashakha. Swadhyayo adhyetavyaha, that's the Shruti Vakya. So based on that, each one has to study their own shakha. But where does that study end? So that study ends up to, there are two, three views on this. So the view that Vedantins generally take is, I think Vivaranakara's view. So Ratna Prabhakara, he brings in this view that you have to study till the end of, the end of conclusion of studies when you know the meaning also. So along with the meaning, you have to study the Veda, but then first you study the text of the Veda, then you do a Mimamsa and then study the meaning of the Vedas. That was the scheme. So these people are Veda Paragaha. That means they have not just studied the text of the Veda, they have also gone up and studied the meaning also. That's the meaning of Veda Paragaha. So Veda Paragaha, Vidhivat Karma Kurvanti, and Yatha, and what is that Vidhivat? Vidhivat, he's explaining Yatha Vidhi, Yatha Nyayam, Parikramanti Shastrataha. So Yatha Vidhi means according to the Kalpa Sutra. So Kalpa Sutra is the manual, how you should do and things like that. So it's like you first you do this, first then you do this, then do this, that is mentioned in the Kalpa Sutra. So that is Yatha Vithi according to the Kalpa Sutras. And then Yatha Nyayam. Nyayam is Mimamsa Shastra. So Yatha Nyayam means, so even this order, in this order sometimes there is a ambiguity as in how you should do things, what you should do, and then you consult the rules of Mimamsa Shastra. So why Mimamsa Shastra is called Nyayam is, so even like in Brahma Sutras we have Adhikaranas, in Jaimini Sutras also you have Adhikaranas. The conclusion of each Adhikarana is called a Nyaya. So it's like a maxim that we use. So the conclusion of each Mimamsa, each Adhikarana in the Mimamsa Sutras is called Nyaya. Therefore Mimamsa Shastra is generally referred to as Nyaya also. Contextually Nyaya can mean Nyaya Darshana itself, or contextually it can mean Mimamsa Shastra also. Here it means Mimamsa Shastra. So interestingly, what is called as law, so for law the Hindi or Sanskrit word that is used is Nyaya. So Nyaya profession, there Nyaya doesn't mean logic, it does not mean Nyaya Shastra. When you are referring to law, there Nyaya does not mean Nyaya as Darshana, but there Nyaya means Mimamsa only actually, because you know even Mimamsakas are interested in interpreting the words of the text and they are masters at it. So how you should interpret the words of the Shruti, they are masters at it. That is being applied in law also, because there's a statute and how you interpret these statutes. So these things are there. So there's a topic in itself. I remember when I was studying CA, so there was a small topic called interpretation of statutes. So if you see, those maxims are similar to what Mimamsakars are saying. Of course, interpretation of statutes is a huge kind of topic, and Mimamsa is also a huge topic, but there are many similarities between them. So these Mimamsakars, so these judges usually study Mimamsa books. So if you see some of these books on Mimamsa Shastra in English and Hindi, so judges usually write such books. Anyway, so Yatha Nyayam, contextually here Nyaya means Mimamsa Shastra. And Shastrataha Parikramanti. Shastrataha Parikramanti means they are doing it according to whatever is the Shastra. I mean, whatever is the Vidhi. So Shastravat here means Yatha Vidhi, Yatha Nyayam, like I said. So there was some interesting meaning which was given to this. I am trying to find that out. So third shloka. So, हाँ सो शास्त्रतः है सो शिक्षा युक्ता शिक्षां कुर्वन्ति सो एनीवे सो दैट्स व्हाट दे आर सेइंग सो दे डोंट आई रिमेंबर सीइंग सम मीनिंग आई एम नॉट एबल टू ट्रेस इट आउट सो शास्त्रः परिक्रामन्ति मींस सो दे डोंट दे आर डूइंग अकॉर्डिंग टू द शास्त्र दे आर नॉट क्रॉसिंग द लिमिट्स ऑफ द शास्त्र सो क्रॉसिंग द वट एवर प्रोसीजर ऑफ द शास्त्र एनीवे प्रवर्ग्यम शास्त्रतः कृत्वा तथैवोप तत्र तथैवोपसदं द्विजाः चक्रुश्च विधिवत् सर्वम् अधिकं कर्मशास्त्रतः सो नाउ सो आर सर्टेन डिटेल्स व्हाट आर दोज स्मॉल यज्ञास विच कॉन्स्टिट्यूट द मेजर यज्ञ कॉल्ड अश्वमेध इटसेल्फ सो सम ऑफ देम आर बीइंग मेंशनड हियर सो वन इज सो प्रवर्ग्यम शास्त्रतः कृत्वा सो यू हैव टू डिफरेंशिएट अगेन सो सम मीमांसा थिंग्स विल कम अप इन दिस चैप्टर टुडे So the things are so I told you something like Advaryu and things like that. Another thing is so there is something called karma and there's something called ishti. So you have to broadly, I'm telling you a rough definition between both of them. Ishti is something that you have fire and you put oblations in the fire, then it will be called ishti. And karma means a general kind of what should I say? Karma is a particular action. Karma is also mandated by Shruti. Ishti is also mandated by the Shruti. So karma is something in which there is no, you know, there is no oblation of ahuti in the fire. Some such things are not there, but it's an action. It's a ritual that you have to do because Veda has said. So there are two things, karma and ishti. So this pravargya is a karma. So pravargya karma is after you have. So there is an entire brahmana. It's called pravargya brahmana in Taittiriya Aranyaka. It's there, I think. Of course, in Shukla Yajurveda also it must be there. I don't know. So this pravargya ritual. So there are books on that also, pravargya ritual and things like that. So this pravargya is something that you do after you. So you have to buy soma lata. So soma creeper you have to buy. Once you buy that, this pravargya ritual is done. That's what Tikakaras are saying. I don't know much details about these things. I know that there's a pravargya brahmana. Anyway, so these things are there. So whether that pravargya brahmana is related to this, that also I'm not very sure. But then pravargya brahmana is there in Taittiriya Shakha also you have that. So pravargyam shastratah kritva. So according to shastras, they did the pravargya ritual and then tathaivopasadam dvijaha those brahmanas also did upasada so this upasada is an ishti so this upasada ishti they did and then chakruscha vidhivat sarvam adhikam karma shastratah so vidhivat chakruhu so according to the vidhi they did this and what is this adhikam karma so they did something according to vidhi and they did something more also that's a literal meaning but you should not take it that way this adhikam karma means so shastratah adhikam karma chakruhu means So you should understand in the Vedas how these ishtis or how these yajna itself will be mentioned. So now there will be a topic called Ashwamedha Yajna that will start. I mean, so in the mantras it will be like that. So once Ashwamedha starts, all the details relating to Ashwamedha Yaga will be given at one place. Sometimes another Yaga will be there as though it is starting newly. I mean, a different kind of yaga will be there. Then there are rules as to whether this yaga that is starting now is it an independent yaga or is it an ancillary yaga of the Ashwamedha. So these things are precisely what Mimamsakas discuss. They have rules to this to say that to determine whether some yaga that is started now is it an independent yaga or is it a part of the Ashwamedha yaga. Some things are there. I mean, you find like that. And then there is something called Prakriti Yaga and Vikriti Yaga. So Prakriti Yaga is the main format, it's a standard format of a particular Yaga. And then there is something called Vikriti Yaga. So Vikriti Yaga is, so Vikriti Yaga, the rule is, so Prakriti Vat Vikriti you should do. In all things for which Prakriti Yaga specific instructions are not given, for that, Vikriti Yaga is, so Prakriti Yaga is a Yaga which all details of the Yaga are given from starting to the end, everything is in detail, it is discussed. So that's called Prakriti Yaga. Vikriti Yaga, only specific instructions are given. So those aspects of that Yaga for which specific instructions are not given, that you should follow the format of the Prakriti Yaga. And where specific instructions are given, so instead of that portion, instead of following the Prakriti Yaga's format, you should follow what is specifically mentioned in the Vikriti Yaga. So, I mean, such things are there. So what I'm trying to say is in some context, so you may not, so suppose some yaga starts, discussion about a yaga starts, you may not find vidhis pertaining to that yaga there. You have to find it from somewhere else. Of course, there are mimamsa rules for that, how you should bring in, what you should consider and bring in. So this adhikam karma means that for which, so this is called an atidesha. You have to bring in an from somewhere else, you have to bring in here. So a shruti vakya for this context of the yaga. So that is what he's meaning. So adhikam karma means does not mean something that is not there in the shastras, that also they did. No, it means something that is not specifically mentioned in the context of that yaga, that also they did. Why did they do? Because they have to do it. Shastrataha, they have to do it because the details are not completely given. When details are not completely given, that means it's a vikriti yaga, and then you have to bring in portions of the missing details from the prakriti yaga. So that's the meaning. I hope I was clear. But anyway, so adhikam karma shastrataha, I'm trying to say that it's not something that, yeah, shastra said something, they did it, and they did something more also. Like in weddings, you will see, in weddings, in Indian weddings, there are some common elements, it's usually from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, everybody does those elements. And then there are some things which are different, like in Tamilian weddings, you have one swing ceremony, so unjal. And then in Telugu weddings, you have something where people pour rice on each other's heads. So this is not there. So swing is not, unjal is not there here, and this talambralu is not there in Tamilian wedding. So what is that? So that is something. So that is the, what should I say, family practice or the deshachara it's called. So such things, so it's not like that. It's not something that Shastra has said it and then we are doing something more. This is not the meaning I was trying to say. So this chapter is going to be a little technical. You have to be patient because some yaga details are coming. I'm not even going into details. So if I tell you from Govinda, so Govinda Raja's commentary, truth be told, some of it I don't understand because I'm not a Mimamsa expert. But then there are some things that I understand, but I'm not saying it because it makes the kind of discussion even more elaborate. I'm just trying to say some interesting things. So all these things, Prakriti, Vikriti, Yaga, such things are, I mean, these are used in, if you study some kind of advanced Vedanta text, even in Bhashya, sometimes it comes up. And then in texts like Advaita Siddhi and things like that, it comes up. So if all of you will study such texts in future, I'm sure, so these things might be useful. So I'm saying only those things which are relevant to as students of Vedanta. Anyway, so Abhipujya Tada Krishta Sarve Chakrur Yatha Vidhi Pratasavana Purvani Karmani Munipungavaha. So Abhipujya. So Abhipujya means having worshipped. So whom did they worship? That's not mentioned here. So Abhipujya, I should say, you should take Devatas. They worship Devatas. So Yatha Vidhi, they worship the Devata. So these Ritviks who are there, so they also have to do their Swakarma, you know, they have to do their Sandhyavandana and things like that and then do the Yaga. So you can take in that sense also. So the devatas that have to be worshipped in the yaga, they did that. And some devatas that they have to personally worship, that also they did. So Abhipujya Tada is there. That's why I said they do their own Swakarma and then go. That's the meaning I brought, because Tada, that is, after they perform their own Swakarma, then they are doing this Yaga's Karma also. That interpretation also you can give. So Abhipujya Tada Hrishta. Hrishta is, they are happy. I mean, they have some kind of contentment. Like in the last session, Prasadji was pointing out, so there is some prasada in the heart. And why is that prasada coming out? Because they are all of them, they are doing it in the sense of a karma yoga. I mean, nobody has any personal stakes in it. Everybody is doing because it's the thing to be done in that, or in that sense. So they are doing it. So they are always, there is contentment in the heart when you do things that has to be done. So it's kartavya karma, therefore you are doing it. When you do kartavya karma, so there's always a sense of, sense of happiness in you. So Pujya Swamiji, so if I say Pujya Swamiji, it means Swami Dayananda Saraswati. So Pujya Swamiji used to say that if something, so for a long time something is pending, you have to do. Once you do that, so you feel a sense of contentment. So again, I lost connection briefly. What I'm trying to say was Pujya Swamiji used to say that if there's a pending work for a long time and you do it, it gives you a lot of satisfaction because that is a karma that you should have done in the first place. So it's kartavya karma to do. So it gives you some kind of satisfaction. Anyway, so Hrishta Sarve Chakru Yatha Vidhi Abhipujya. That's the connection. Now Pratasavana Purvani Karmani Munipungavaha. So this again you have to say Pratasavana Karmani Yatha Vidhi Chakru. So now there are some things that you have to do in the morning, some things that have to be done in the evening, and then something afternoon, and then something that you have to do in the evening. So all these three Valmiki will mention now. So Pratasavana, so they did the Pratasavana. They did, and then that also they did. So Munipungavaha, these great munis, that Pratasavana also they did according to the Vidhi. So Pratasavana Purvani Karmani. So these karmas which are related to this Pratasavana, those karmas these people did. And then Aindrascha Vidhivad Datto Raja Chabhishuto Naghaha Madhyandinan Chasavanam Pravartata Yathakramam. So the second half of the shloka is maybe obvious to you. So they did the Madhyandina Savana also. So something that has to be done in the afternoon, that also they did. So Yathakramam is in that order. What has to be done first, they did it. And then, now what is this Aindrascha Vidhivad Dattaha? So this Aindra, so So there are again there is some Mimamsa to this. I'm not going to in such detail, but let me brief. So what has to be given to Indra? They gave. So Vidhivat Dattaha. So Indraha Vidhivat Dattaha. That means what has to be given to Indra according to Vidhi. They did that. So we have something called so Aindri Rig and things like that. So there are some things which has to be given as an offering to Indra. So those things have been done. And then Raja. So Raja cha Abhishutaha Abhishutaha. Abhishu Raja Anagha Abhishutaha. So Raja here, if you see Valmikiramayan.net, that I mean the translation there, Raja, he will translate it as Dasharatha, so it's wrong. So Raja means actually Soma. So Somalata is called Raja here. So Somo Raja like that. There are mantras like that. So Raja here means Somalata because Abhishutaha. Abhishutaha means that which has been properly kind of pasted. I mean that so what should I say? Crushed. So you crush the Somalata and bring out the Soma Rasa, the juice. So that has been done. So Abhishutaha means so crushed, so grinded. So Raja here is Somalata. Soma has been nicely grinded. So nicely grinded means you take out the rasa out of it. So how that Somalata is grinded, for that also there is a sutra itself of Jaimini. So on four directions, this Hota, Atvaryu, then Udgata and Brahma, all four of them on four directions they go, sit around that what is it called, the press. The press, they sit around it in four directions and then they press the Somalata and bring out the juice. So that also has been done according to Vidhi, he's saying. So that has been done. The Soma Rasa has been extracted. What should be given to Indra, that has been given. Madhyandina Savana also has been conducted. And then he's telling, so Sayantana Savana is there, evening Savana is left. That also he's telling now. Tritiya Savane Chaiva चक्रुस्ते शक्रतो दृष्ट्वा यथा ब्राह्मण पुंगवाः. सो दिस ब्राह्मण पुंगवाः, दिस ग्रेट ब्राह्मणास. सो पुंगवा मीन्स मेल मेल काउ वट एवर, सो एन ऑक्स आई सपोज. सो बट इट लिटरली मीन्स दैट, बट एक्चुअली इट मीन्स श्रेष्ठ. सो ब्राह्मण श्रेष्ठा. सो शास्त्रतः चक्रुः, सो दृष्ट्वा यथा, सो शास्त्रतः दृष्ट्वा यथा ब्राह्मण पुंगवाः. सो दे आई मीन दे डिड वॉट एवर इज अकॉर्डिंग टू शास्त्र, दे डिड इट. दैट्स द मीनिंग. सो आह्वयाचक्रिरे शक्रादीन विबुधोत्तमान ऋष्यशृंगादयो मंत्रैः शिक्षाक्षर समन्वितैः. सो दिस इज आई थिंक होता. सो आह्वयान चक्रिरे, सो सो चक्रिरे मीन्स इन्वाइटेड. सो दे डिड द आह्वान ऑफ शक्रादीन विभुदोत्तमान. शक्रा इज इंद्र. सो शक्रा इंद्र एंड अदर विभुदा, एक्चुअली विभुदा मीन्स अ वाइस मैन. हियर इट मीन्स देवता. सो विभुदोत्तमान मीन्स देवता, श्रेष्ठ श्रेष्ठ उत्तम देवता. सो ग्रेट देवता इंद्र एंड अदर देवता Ahvana. So how do you now do an Ahvana? You recite the mantra, so that means the devata is now welcomed. And once the devata is welcomed, then you give the oblation to the devata. So you welcome the devata, you do a stuti of the devata, and you offer the oblation to the devata. That's how it proceeds. So you can see in YouTube, I suppose that those videos are there. So this what is that yaga? So Soma, one of the Soma Yagas. So I don't remember the name exactly. So it's a very famous video. That's how they say it was revived. So this Yaga system, Yajna system, was lost for some time, and then there was this American, I suppose, Fritz Stahl. So he brought in some amount of funding from America, and then he these Nambudris in Kerala somehow convinced them that you have to do this Yaga, and then he wanted to document it. So they did it very nicely. He also documented it very nicely. So credit has to be given to him. So in that you can see how they buy the Somalata, how they crush it and things like that. And you can see how they recite the mantras. It's a very interesting documentary that you might want to see. So there you can, if you watch that and read the Sarga, then you can somehow connect what they are trying to do. So they recite that mantra, and then that means the devata is now welcome. So something like that. So Ahvayan Chakri days, they welcome the devas. So Aushat you send, you offer the oblation. I'm telling it बट देन एनीवे दे वेलकम द देवता एंड ऑफर द ऑब्लेशन आह्वयान चक्रीरे तत्र शक्रादि विभुदोत्तमान ऋषि श्रृंगादयः सो हाउ डिड दे वेलकम थ्रू मंत्र सो मंत्रैहि आह्वयान चक्रीरे सो शिक्षाक्षर समन्वितैहि हाउ आर दीज मंत्रास दे आर शिक्षाक्षर समन्वितैहि सो तिलककर इज नाइसली एक्सप्लेनिंग व्हाट डस शिक्षाक्षर समन्वितैहि मीन्स सो शिक्षाक्षर समन्वितैहि शिक्षा शिक्षाभ्यास कालः सो शिक्षा मीन्स अभ्यास काल so that the time which is spent in gurukula and they learned the vedas so that is called shiksha tatra grihitani aksharani shiksha aksharani so that the letters or the letters of the veda that you learned during your gurukula vasa that's the meaning of shiksha aksharani means that's the so shiksha akshara literally means the veda mantras that you learned during your gurukulam that's a literal meaning what it means is so veda mantras without any doshas they recited through Veda mantras without any doshas, through those mantras they invited these devatas. Now, gati bhirma dhurai snigdhaihi mantrahvanair yatharhataha hotaro daduravahya havirbhagan divaukasam. So, gati bhihi, so now this is about these, this is about the hota. So maybe the previous one was about the Udgata, I don't know. So this is about Hota anyway. So so it has to be about Udgata, I don't know, I'm missing something. So Gatibhihi Madhuraihi Snigdhaihi Mantraihi. So this Gatibhihi is very melodious mantras, Madhuraihi which is very sweet, so Snigdhaihi very kind of attractive, so Mantraihi through these mantras, so ninth shloka. So Gatibhihi means Yathochita. Gana Vishishtaihi. So Gatibhihi Gati actually. So I think this has come before also. Sorry, Gitibhihi. You are right. So Gati, I was trying to say what is this Gati. So in music you have something called Gati. So Gati is like the tempo. So anyway, I was trying to bring in that meaning. Thanks for pointing out. Gitibhihi. So that's why I'm thinking this is actually the Udgata, the Samaveda Gayaka. So Gitibhihi Madhuraihi. Madhura means very sweet to listen to. So Gitibhihi Madhuraihi Madhura Swara Vishishtaihi, so they are very pleasant to listen to. Then Snigdhaihi means Manoramaihi, they are very captivating. So if you listen to Samaveda, it does sound like that. I mean, it's not something that you have to listen to for kind of, what should I say, entertainment. So somebody told me Vedic chanting, especially Samaveda, is an acquired taste. Acquired taste means you listen to it more and more, then you feel attractive. No, that's not the purpose for which you have to listen to these mantras, but for when the context comes, when a yaga is being performed or when a ritual is being performed, when you hear these mantras, it does sound very captivating. So snigdhaihi mantrahvanair yatharhataha. So mantrahvanaihi means ahvana mantraihi. So these mantras which are used to do ahvana, so which are used for ahvana, those mantras are recited and the devatas are welcomed. Yathar hataha, what is appropriate. So Indra mantras are used for Indra, Varuna mantras are used for Varuna and things like that. So Hotaraha daduru daduhu ahva avahya daduhu. That means these hotas, so these hotrus, they welcome these devatas. They do the ahvana through mantra and then they give these so havirbhagan daduhu. So these havis, I mean the oblations that they have to give to the devatas, they give. To whom they give? Divaukasam. So divaukasas means people who, so divaukasas means devatas. And what's the meaning? So aukas means so abode. So these people for whom the heaven is the abode. And who are those people? They are devatas. Nachahutam abhutatras khalit. दृश्यते ब्रह्मवत्सर्वं क्षेमयुक्तं हि चक्रिरे सो नचाहूतम अभूत तत्र सो देर इज नथिंग देर विच इज नॉट ऑफर्ड सो दैट मीन्स देर इज नथिंग देर विच इज नॉट ऑफर्ड अकॉर्डिंग टू विधि सो नचाहूतम अभूत सो अहूतम सॉरी नॉट आहूतम नचाहूतम अभूत सो देर इज नथिंग दैट इज नॉट प्रॉपरली अकॉर्डिंग टू विधि there is nothing there which has been offered not according to the vidhi, that's the meaning. And skhalitam va, skhalitam means that something which has been dropped away, that means vidhi has said that you have to do like, but didn't do. So there is nothing like that, there is nothing that has been left out of the vidhi, and there is nothing that has been offered in contradiction to the Vidhi Vakya. Vidhi has said something, they have followed it to the letter and spirit. That's the meaning. And then because they have followed it to the letter and spirit, so Brahmavat Sarvam Drishyate. So all this karma that they are doing, Brahmavat Sarvam Drishyate. So it's looking like Brahma. That's the literal meaning. So Brahma here means, so Brahmavat means according to mantras. That means according to the Vidhi. So everything, if a person who's an expert in Ashwamedha Yaga, if he's seeing those things, then he will say, yeah, they are doing according to the Vidhi. That's the meaning. Brahmavat Sarvam Drishyate means everything appears to be in accordance to the Vedic mantras. That means whatever has to be done is being done there. Kshemayuktam hi chakrire. So Kshemayuktam, chakrire means it was done. So they did it. So Kshemayuktam means without any vignas or without any kind of doshas, they did it. So when they are doing it, they didn't have any doshas in what they are doing. And when they are doing it, they didn't face any vignas also. So Shreyamsi Bahu Vignani, it's called. If you want, I mean, they say like that. So if you want to do something good, there will always be many vignas, they say. So, but then here, because by Ishwara's grace and by Rishyashringa's presence and Vasishta, Vamadeva and those Mahatmas are there, because of that, there was no vighna at all.
Nateshvah sushranto va krudhito va nadrishyate navidvan brahmanah kaschin nashatan kaschin nashatanucharastatha.
So these few shlokas that come are now easy shlokas. So I mean, they are not technical. So teshvahasu, in those days when the yaga was being performed, na shrantaha, there was nobody who was tired. As in, some tikakaras go into his description. I mean, it's not like he was busy doing the yaga and forgot about his food or thing like that. He ate properly. That's the meaning, because now the context is about feeding people. So that's what is being coming here. Anyway, so Natesh Vahasu Shrantaha means in those days. So aha means days, ahasu means in those days. In those days means in those days where yaga was performed, being performed. Teshvah ahasu means in those days. Teshu means in those. So in those days, Nashrantaha, there was Nashrantaha Drishyate, there was nobody who was tired. As in, I have to do this yaga, but I'm not able to do. There was nobody who thought like that. Nakshudhitaha, there was nobody who was hungry. So Shrantaha, Shrikakaras are telling, Shrantaha means one who was thirsty. So there is nobody who was thirsty, there was nobody who was hungry. And then Navidwan Brahmanaha Drishyate, there was no Brahmana there who was not a Vidwan. That means, all Brahmanas there were all very well-read scholars. Only such Brahmanas were around. And then Kaschit means there was nobody at all. So Kaschin Nashatanucharaha. So everybody, there was no person involved in the, that means these Ritviks and all of them who were involved in the Yaga, there was none of them who was not assisted by 100 people. So that means it was an elaborate yaga. Each one have to have many assistants to perform the yaga properly. So there were everybody were very well, what should I say, help was given to them, and they did it properly, nicely, and that's the meaning. So like I said, 4 Ritviks are there, and each Ritvik again has 4 kind of assistants. So 16 people will be there, 16 plus 4, 20. So this briefly comes up in Mundaka Upanishad, and then Anandagiri, there he writes who are those 4 people for each of them. So these 4. So 4 main Ritviks and their 4 assistants each. And then he's telling each one was assisted by 100 people. That means the details of the yaga, I mean, you have to get this, you have to get that from there. Such things are also being very well assisted in their performance of the duty.
Now, Brahmana bhunjate nityam, nathavantascha bhunjate, tapasa bhunjate chapi shamanaschaiva bhunjate, vriddhascha vyadhitascha stribalascha tathaiva cha. Anisham bhunjamana nam natrupti rupalabhyate.
So everybody was being fed very nicely. They are feeding them. They all ate. Who all ate? Brahmana bhunjate. Brahmanas ate. Nathavantascha bhunjate. Nathavantaha means, so Natha is a master. So Nathavan means one who has a master. That means one who is serving somebody. That means here contextually it means a shudra. So shudras also ate. So this is the greatness, you see, like I told you in the last session. So everybody is fed. So everybody is given equal kind of, what should I say, respect. And nobody is, so Vasishta said these words, if you remember. So you should not kind of neglect anybody. So Brahmana bhunjate, Nityam bhunjate. So at all times they were being very well fed. Nathavantascha bhunjate, Tapasa bhunjate. So these tapaswins are there. So Tikakaras are telling. Tapasas means, so Tapasvi here means. So there are some Shudras who are not serving somebody. So they are kind of independent Shudras. Those people are called tapasvins, he is telling. And then Shramanascha Bhunjate. So these Shramanas means, so these people are saying, Tikakara is telling, Shramana means a Bauddha Bhikshu. So Bauddha Bhikshus were there during Rama's time, but how can it be? It cannot be because historically came after Rama. So where did it come from? So Shramana you should take. Shramana means what we call as ashrami in our Sanatana, whatever usage. So Brahmacharya, Grihastha, Vanaprastha and Sannyasa. See, Sannyasa, which one is called an ashrama, right? So that is the Shramanaha means literally it means one who puts in each of kind of ashramas. So you can take that way, or you can take a general sannyasi also. That meaning is also being given by Tikakaras. So Shramanaha can mean a sannyasi in general, or Shramanaha can mean anybody in any ashrama. I told you a definition of ashrama which Tikakaras gave. Ashrama is ashrama asamantat shrama nivartakam, where all shrama is removed. That place is called ashrama, or ashrama in the sense of grihastha ashrama, brahmacharya ashrama. In that sense, ashrama means that in which there is lot of effort, lot of shrama is there. That is called ashrama there. So in that context, it means ashrama means people who put a lot of effort. So it means people of all ashramas. They also ate. Vruddhascha, so old people also ate. Vyadhitascheva, even sick people were very well fed. Sthrilascha, also stri bala, so women and children, they were also fed. And then how were they fed? Anisham bhun, so they anisham, say they all had, so always they had food. And then this bhunjamananam natripti rupalabhyate, anisham bhunjamananam, people who have been eating again and again. So this line can be interpreted in two ways. Anisham bhunjamananam natripti rupalabhyate means these people who have been eating at appropriate times are being very well fed, still they were not very content, they were not satisfied. Why? Because so Tilakara is very nicely saying, it seems it's very tasty food, but our stomachs are small, so our stomachs are full, but the tongue is not yet happy. I mean, it's not yet contented, it wants more. That's the atripti that Valmiki is talking about. That's one atripti. That's one way of interpreting this line. So anisham bhunjamananam natripti rupalabhyate can mean from the standpoint of the people who are eating. It means these people, the food is so tasty that they want to eat more and more and more, but the stomach is full. Unfortunately, they can't eat anymore. So therefore, there is atripti. The other kind of interpretation that you can give, which Tilakakara himself is telling, the other interpretation is Dasharatha is not contented, that even though so many people are eating, Dasharatha is still not happy. He was wishing, I wish I could feed more people. Such kind of atripti is there. So in both senses, the atripti there is a praise, you know. It's not so when you, there is a saying that what is the greatest danam. So the greatest danam is annadanam, because it's the only danam where the person who's taking the danam will feel contented and says, I don't want any more. Because any other danam, suppose you give him 1 lakh, then he will say, I wish I got 10 lakhs. But it's annadanam alone where if you feed a person, there will come a point where he says, I don't want any more, because his stomach is full. So anadanam is great. So this atrupti here is not negative sense. The atrupti is a praise of the anadanam that's going on. So atrupti, because it's very tasty food. In that sense, there is atrupti. Or Dasharatha, though so many people are eating, I wish I could do more. That kind of atrupti. In both sense, it's a praise only. Anyway. So diyatam annam vasamsi vividhani cha iti sanchoditas tatra tatha chakrur anekashah. So people, so Dasharatha is telling, so diyatam annam, so you feed more and more people. And then vasamsi vividhani cha, you give more clothes. So anadanam and vastradanam is being constantly performed. So Dasharatha is telling, give more, feed more people, give more clothes. So vasamsi means clothes, and vividhani means variety of clothes. So vividhani means a variety. So in Shweta, we are not going to complete the sarga today. So let me just tell an interesting point. So vividha in Shweta Shvatara Upanishad. So there's a mantra like that. So parasya shaktihi vividhaiva shruyate. That's the mantra. So there vividha means So vividha means it has many. So that shakti of that Parabrahman is vividha. That means it's very manifold. I mean, the shakti is kind of unlimited. You cannot count the variety of that shakti. So that's one meaning. Or you can also say, so in Chennai there is a temple, Kapalishwarar temple. So that place is called Mailapur. So I see on Facebook these days that they are trying to change names of all these places. I don't know. But then Mailapur there means, so that there's a story like that. If I remember the story nice correctly, the story is Parvati Devi takes the form of a peacock and then she dances to entertain Shiva, something like that. So that is the vividha. So vi means pakshi. So pakshi vidha. So vividha means like a, so the shakti of that Brahman is like a bird. That interpretation also is given there in Shvetashvatara Upanishad. So Shekharendra Saraswati wrote a stotram called Durga Pancharatnam. So in that he writes, so Parasya Shaktihi Vividhaiva Shruyate. So that Mayuri is that, so Mayuri means peacock. So he's referring to that story in that shloka. So Vividha means like a bird. So the Shakti of Brahman is like a bird. Anyway, this Vividha suddenly took me there. So Vividha here does not mean bird or something. Vividha just means like variety of garments. So variety means what is appropriate to the young people. He's giving certain kind of garments. Old people, he's giving certain type of garments. Or you can take for women. So there are different types of, I mean, fabric available, right? So there he's giving different types of garments. Iti sanchoditas tatra tatha chakrur anekasha. Iti sanchoditaha. There are people there who are distributing food and clothes. These people are being pushed, or these people are being instigated or inspired by whom? That's not being mentioned. You have to take by Dasharatha. Dasharatha is telling those people, feed them more, give them more clothes. So they are saying, he's telling those people like that, and they are also doing like that. Tatha chakrur anekashaha. Those people are doing like that. As Dasharatha is telling, they are also doing like that. It's not like you can see sometimes that the master or owner will be telling something, but the people who are working for him, they will say, he will tell like that, we have to be prudent, you have to give them one cloth is enough, then one serving is enough. It's not like that. He is telling it. These people are also doing accordingly. Anna kutashta drishyante bahavah parvatopamaha. Divase divase tatra siddhasya vidhivattada. So annakuta means annaparvata. That means these people, so annakuta is, so this food, you know, food is being cooked and it has to be served in between. So between the food being ready after cooking and between serving, so there is some gap, you know. I mean, in the sense that food is, it's not like literally from the fire you go and serve. You collect it at one place. So how are they collecting? They are putting all that food in one place, and that accumulated food, that collected food looks like a mountain. So parvata. So that is annakuta. Annakuta means the food, rice, everything is piled up in one place. It's so much rice is being served that it's looking like a mountain. Annakuta, annakutascha drishyante. And not just one annakuta, he's using plural. So annakuta, many annakutas are being seen there. Bahavaha, parvatopamaha, they are looking like as though. So annakuta means piling up of food, and that piling up is looking like a parvata, parvatopamaha. Divase divase tatra siddhasya vidhivatta. Divase divase means day after day, so much food is being presented there. And vidhivat tada siddhasya. So vidhivat here you can say, there are two meanings which are being given by the Tikakara. So vidhivat means according to the Shastra is telling you have to do more and more anadanam. So Dasharatha is doing that. Then vidhivat siddhasya, you can take that way. So this siddhasya means what? This siddhasya means well cooked food. So according to vidhi is being given. Vidhivat siddhasya also you can say, that means, so it seems amusing to me. So Tikakara is telling vidhivat siddhasya means according to the culinary shastra is there, you know, the shastra of cooking food. So this food is cooked according to that cooking shastra. So that very nicely they are cooking. So you can see perhaps these cooks, chefs as a profession was there even at that time. So vidhivat siddhasya divase divase tatra parvatopamaha drishyante. So this annakuta. So annakuta, interestingly, North India they do after the next day after Diwali in Vrindavan specifically, they do something called annakuta. So it's called annakut. That means all food items are piled up in one place and they are offered to Ishvara.
So let me just finish those next two shlokas and we will stop. Nanadeshadanupraptaha purusha striganastatha annapanai suvihitastasminyagne mahatmanaha. So nanadeshadanupraptaha so striga purushaha striganaha. So these men and women who have come from many places. So nanadeshadanupraptaha, people who have assembled from many places, men and women. So annapanaihi suvihitaha. So these people are well taken care of by giving them food and water to drink. So annapanaihi suvihitaha tasmin yagne. So tasmin mahatmanaha yagne, in that yagna of that Mahatma Dasharatha, men and women who have come from far off places, many places, all of them they are being well taken care of, well attended to, by giving them food and water to drink at very lavishly. So as much they want, they can eat in that way. अन्नम हि विधिवत् स्वादु प्रशंसन्ति द्विजर्षभाः अहो तृप्तास्म भद्रंते इति शुश्रावराघवः. इट्स अ नाइस श्लोका टू एंड विथ आल्सो. सो अन्नम हि विधिवत् स्वादु प्रशंसन्ति. सो दिस अगेन यू कैन इंटरप्रेट इन टू वेज. सो दिस द्विजर्षभाः, दिस द्विजास ब्राह्मणास. सो बाय द वे इन 12th श्लोका व्हेन ही सॉ ब्राह्मणाः भुञ्जन्ते, सो आई फॉरगॉट टू टेल यू, Tikakara is telling there you have to take Brahmana means Trivarnikas there, because Natha Vantashta Bhunjate is there, Shudras are being mentioned, Brahmanas are being mentioned, what about Kshatriyas and Vaishyas if you ask? So he is telling Brahmanas means you include all of them, because all of them are Dvijas, so those three and then Natha Vantaha. Anyway, Dvijarshvaha, Brahmanas you can take, and you can take Lakshanaya, you can take other people also, everybody, they are Annam hi Vidhivat Swadu Prashamsanti. So they are praising that food, that it is vidhivat swadu, it is something that has been cooked appropriately according to the diet shastra or culinary shastra. It's being very nicely, cooking shastra, very nicely it's been cooked. Such annam, these people are prashamsanti, they are praising. Or you can also take very interestingly vidhivat prashamsanti. So the Valmiki seems to say that you have to praise the giver of the food. So after you eat food that has been given to you, so you have to go and tell them, thank you very much, the food was very tasty, and things like that. That is the vidhi he's telling as though. So vidhivat prashamsanti, or you can take vidhivat swadu. So vidhivat prashamsanti is it is mandated that you have to go and praise and thank the person who has given you food. So we see in practice generally after eating at somebody's house, so we will say annadata sukhi bhava, so you have given me food, so may you be happy. That is what these people also are telling in the next half of the shloka. Aho truptasma bhadram te. So this iti shushrava raghavaha, this raghavaha hears dasharatha, dasharatha heard. So what did he hear? Aho truptasma. So they are telling, oh dasharatha, we are very contented, very satisfied, bhadram te. So may good happen to you. So this is again and again, so many shouts, chants of these things. So aho truptasma bhadramte, this is Raghavaha. Dasharatha is listening to these kind of blessings from these people who are very happy, contented after eating this tasty food. And they are also blessing him and thanking him because it's the appropriate thing to do. It's a nice thing to do to thank and praise the, the Annadata, the giver of the food. So let me stop here. I'll just add one point. So Annadana details is given even in Mahabharata. So when Raja Suvi Yaga is performed, so there are some details like that. So people are very well fed and people are happy anyway. So Om Yatra Yatra Raghunatha Kirtanam Tatra Tatra Krita Mastakanjalim Bashpavari Paripurna Lochanam Marutim Namata Rakshasantakam Om Pur Namadav Pur Namidam Pur Nath Pur Namudachate Pur Nasya Pur Namadaya Pur Nameva Vishishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. हरि ओम तत्सत् श्रीरामार्पणमस्तु.